Namaskar everybody, I'm Rashmi Agarwal, PGT Economics, and today I'm going to explain you a topic of class 12, that is Indian economy on the eve of independence. In this unit, I'm going to explain you about what is an economy, features of Indian economy prior to independence, state of the major sectors of India, that is the state of agricultural sector, industrial sector, foreign sector, infrastructure, demographic structure, occupational structure, and even I'm going to tell you about some positive impacts of British rule prior independence. So let's with the meaning of economy. What do we understand of economy? An economy consists of all production units or institutions such as farms, factories, workshops, mines, shops, railway stations, hospitals, schools. That means all these activities which generate revenue, money for the economy is known as economic activities. And these activities are related to economy. Now, I'm going to tell you the features of the Indian economy. The first one, that Indian economy at the time of independence was a feeder economy for the growing British industries. India was supplying raw materials for the fast-growing British industries and was also a ready market for the machine-made British goods. India was a semi-feudal economy. It means that which is neither completely feudal nor completely capitalist. And during this phase, the land settlement system was introduced by Lord Cornwallis in the year 1893. And this has given birth to the feudal relations, that is the relationship between the landlord and the tenants. Indian economy was a stagnant economy. What does stagnation mean? Stagnation means no further growth and development of the economy. That means Indian economy was constant, stagnant. Indian economy was underdeveloped as well. That means an economy in which level of per capita income and consequently living standard is very low. Indian economy was a depleted economy. Now, what is a depleted economy? That means, you know, in an economy when there are no arrangements to replace the depreciated physical assets on account of their excessive use. That means we are using the capital goods continuously, but we don't have that much of capital sufficient with us that we can replace this machinery so that our efficiency and effectiveness increases. So Indian economy was a depleted economy. It was a dependent economy and we were completely dependent on the foreign world for the machine-made and capital goods. Indian economy was a disintegrated economy as well because, you know, Britishers, they divided our country into two parts, that is India and Pakistan. And the division of the country had deeply shaken the Indian economy. And as a result, Indian economy became stagnant, disintegrated, dependent. Now, I'm going to tell you about the state of agriculture and industrial sector on the eve of independence, that is prior independence. Indian agriculture was stagnant. There were, no improvement in the agricultural sector. Around 70 to 75% of the total workforce of our country was completely dependent on agriculture. And, you know, around 58% of the agriculture sector, it has contributed towards the national income then. So, despite such a large population being dependent on agriculture sector, there were no development, no growth in that sector. And our farmers were forced to produce cash crops rather than food crops. So, the Britishers, they have forced commercialization of agriculture for their benefit. And what was their benefit? Because our raw materials, that is agricultural produce, the cash crops, they serve as a ready raw material for the British industry. Indian agriculture sector was heavily dependent on the vagaries of the nature, rainfall. And even, you know, the state of agriculture says that India was suffering from subsistence farming, which means that the farmers who were cultivating on the farms, whatever they were cultivating, the productivity was only sufficient to satiate them, and they were not able to produce surplus which can be marketed. So again, very poor situation of our country, unfortunately. Now we talk about the industrial sector. Industrial sector was suffering from deindustrialization. When we say industrialization, that means lots of industries. And when we say deindustrialization, just the opposite of industrialization. That means Britishers were not trying to, you know, implement or develop more and more industries in our country. And why it is so? Because deindustrialization was serving twofold objective of the Britishers. Number one, to reduce India to the status of mere exporter of important raw materials. And second, to convert India into a market for finished products of those same industries. There were very few modern industries in the second half of the 19th century. There were certain industries like cotton, jute, iron and steel, you know, paper, sugar, matchbox. But Britishers did not put any efforts to establish further more industries in our country, which led to the setback of our country then. There were also lack of capital good industries. Only hardly, you know, one or two industries was there. And one of the notable industry which was existing then was TISCO, that is Tata Iron and Steel Corporation, which was established in the year 1907. Remember the date. It was established in the year 1907, TISCO. Then the public sector role was also very limited. It was only confined to, you know, railways, power generation, communication, ports, and some other departmental undertakings. But public sector did not, you know, exaggerate, or, you know, it did not elaborate its role in the other areas, which led to, again, you know, setback of the Indian economy. So thank you so much. That's all for today. And we'll continue with the same unit in the next video. Till then, stay home, stay safe. Bye-bye.